Okay. So I'll give a class about significance of initiation.
Yes, Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj. Mm-hmm. So all together, we'd like to welcome Maharaj with all this Bhakti Vignasi Maharaj, all the way from Shri Dham Mayapur. So we will welcome Maharaj ka swagat karenge. Hare Krishna Mohammed ke chand karte hue. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Om Ajnana Timurandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vancha Kaupa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this morning, on the occasion of initiation, we want to speak about the significance behind this initiation process. Are we translating to Hindi, Prabhu? Hare Krishna?
Yes, Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj. So, aaj hum sab Maharaj se diksha samaroh ke is avsar par diksha ke mahatv ke bare mein shravan karne ja rahe hain.
We see in the life of, we see during the time of the appearance of Lord Krishna, he also had a spiritual master. First of all, there was a name-giving ceremony when Gargacharya came to the home of Nanda Maharaj and gave the names to Krishna and Balaram. And then later on, when Krishna was 11 years old, after he killed Kamsa, he released his Vasudeva and Devaki from the prison house of Kamsa. And then Vasudeva immediately wanted Lord Krishna and Balaram that they should go and receive spiritual education from the Guru. And they went to Sandipani Muni's ashram.
और जैसे ही भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने 11 वर्ष की आयु में जब कंस का वध किया उसके पश्चात जब वसुदेव और देवकी को वहां से उन्होंने मुक्त किया तत्पश्चात उनको वसुदेव जी ने संदीपनी मुनि के आश्रम में उज्जैन में वहां पर शिक्षा ग्रहण करने के लिए भेजा.
So that was during the appearance of Lord Krishna, and we see that he showed the importance, although he's the Supreme Lord and he doesn't have to learn anything, but to set the example for everyone, he also went to the spiritual master and he learned. Then we have, during the appearance of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how he went to Gaya and he accepted initiation from Ishwarapuri.
और उसके पश्चात नित्य चतन महाप्रभु जब प्रकट हुए तो वो स्वयं जब गया गए थे तो वहां पर ईश्वरपुर से शिक्षा ग्रहण की.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is also the Supreme Lord. He doesn't need to learn anything, but to teach an example for everyone, he accepted initiation from a spiritual master.
So भगवान चतुर महाप्रभु स्वयं भगवान है, उनको भी आवश्यकता नहीं है दीक्षा ग्रहण करने के, लेकिन जब वो आते हैं तो स्वयं वो अपने आचरण से सिखा रहे हैं, वो भी दीक्षा ग्रहण करते हैं, गुरु ग्रहण करते हैं.
sometimes people wonder, is this necessary? Is it important? Yes, actually, it's essential that one has to be initiated by a spiritual master to, in order to be successful in the path of spiritual advancement. There has to be the blessings of the devotees. And these devotees come in, like, in the form of different spiritual teachers.
कई बार लोग पूछते हैं कि क्या ये आवश्यक है दीक्षा लेना तो हाँ ये बहुत आवश्यक है प्रामाणिक विधि है ये कि ऐसे भक्तों के संपर्क में भक्तों से शिक्षा और दीक्षा ग्रहण करें और बहुत से ऐसे कई भक्त होते हैं जो एक भक्त के जीवन में इस प्रकार से वो प्रभाव डालते हैं
One of the direct disciples of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was Srila Rupa Goswami and Srila Rupa Goswami wrote a very famous book, which is called the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, where he outlines the different process of devotional service.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ke pratyaksh ek jo anivai hai, Shri Rupa Goswami, unhone ek bahut sundar pustak ka avlokan kiya hai, jiska naam hai Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, jisme bhakti ke bahut mahatvapurna tatva ko prakashit kiya gaya hai.
And he has listed all the different items of devotional service which are required, which are part of the process of devotional service. And from all these items, the first five are all in relation to the spiritual teacher.
और उसमें भक्ति के बहुत महत्वपूर्ण अंगों के बारे में चर्चा की गई है और 64 अंगों में से शुरुआत के आरंभ के पांच अंग जो हैं वो आध्यात्मिक गुरु से संबंधित हैं।
Srila Rupa Goswami mentions how you have to take shelter of a spiritual master and you have to render service to the spiritual master and you have to take initiation from the spiritual master. Like this, Rupa Goswami outlines the importance of the connection with the spiritual master.
Shri Rupa Goswami baad usme ye avlokan karte hain ki is prakar se adhyatmik guru ki sharan lena, unki seva karna aur unse diksha lena, is prakar se wo adhyatmik guru ke saath mein sambandh
So then we would like to know what is required actually in order to accept a spiritual master. What is the procedure? You just simply come to the person and say, I want to accept you as my teacher and give me a name and I'll be your disciple.
तो ये जानना भी आवश्यक है कि क्या आवश्यकता है एक शिष्य की ओर से आध्यात्मिक गुरु को ग्रहण करने के लिए क्या हम बस आएं और गुरु के पास जाएं और कहें कि मैं आपको दीक्षा गुरु ग्रहण करना चाहता हूं
You have to understand that we're representing a spiritual society, an institution. And in this institution, there's a common standard for all the devotees who want to become members of the institution, who want to take initiation.
हमें जानना होगा कि ये एक आध्यात्मिक संस्था है प्रामाणिक विधि के द्वारा ये दीक्षा ग्रहण की जाती है और इस प्रामाणिक संस्था के कुछ जो नियम है आदि जो उनके नियम हैं उसको पालन करने की आवश्यकता है
So that standard requires that there's a preliminary phase before one is initiated. One has to first of all be trained for the to come to the standards of spiritual initiation.
इस मानक स्तर के अनुसार जो संस्था के मानक स्तर है पहले जो प्राथमिक चरण है वो ये है कि कुछ अभ्यास करना होता है अभ्यासित होना होता है दीक्षा ग्रहण करने के पहले
First of all, we have four regulative principles which are required for all civilized people, not just simply initiated devotees, but actually all cultured civilized people will follow these four regulative principles.
तो सबसे पहले चार नियमों का पालन करना ये तो एक सभ्य समाज के लिए सभ्य पुरुष के लिए आवश्यक है दीक्षा के लिए नहीं सभ्य पुरुष के लिए भी सबसे पहले उनका पालन सीखना होगा
So these four principles are No meat, fish and eggs, no intoxication, no gambling, no illicit sex.
तो ये चार जो नियम हैं सबसे पहले मछली अंडा या कोई मांस का सेवन नहीं करना अवैध स्त्री पुरुष संग नहीं करना, कोई नशा नहीं करना और कोई जुआ नहीं खेलना.
So people further inquire, they say, well, is that in the scriptures? Is that actually there in the scriptures? And we have to say, yes, it is there in the scriptures. It's mentioned in the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam that the symbol of religious principles comes in the form of the bull, and the bull stands on four legs. Dharma, the bull, stands on four legs. So the four pillars of religion are mentioned in the first canto Srimad Bhagavatam.
So, ha, Srimad Bhagavatam ke pratham skandh mein jab dharma और जब वो बैल और गाय जब उनका वृत्तांत आता है कली का, तो उस समय ये चार जो अधर्म के स्तंभ हैं उनके बारे में वहां पर वर्णन किया गया है.
And these four principles are mentioned: satyam, socham, daya, tapa. Satyam, truthfulness; socham, cleanliness; daya, mercy; and tapa, austerity.
तो वहां पर बताया गया कि ये चार चीजें जो है सत्यम, सोचम, दया और तप, ये चार चीजें वर्णन में बताई गई है.
So truthfulness is destroyed by gambling and lying propaganda.
तो जुआ के द्वारा और इस प्रकार से जो प्रवृत्ति है ये हमारे सत्य को नष्ट करती है.
Socham, cleanliness is destroyed by illicit connection with the opposite sex.
और शौचम जो शुद्धता है वो अवैध संग से दूषित हो जाता है.
Daya, mercy is destroyed by killing of innocent animals and also fish and other living entities.
और दया जो है वो अन्य जीवों की हत्या से, जैसे कि मछली आदि जो मांसाहार है, उससे समाप्त हो जाता है.
And then tapa, austerity is destroyed by too much pride and by intoxication.
और तप जो है वो हमारे गर्व से नष्ट होता है, जैसे कि जब बहुत ज्यादा कोई नशा करते हैं, गर्वित हो जाते हैं उससे.
So these four principles are essential in this society, and if we can encourage more people to follow these principles, the whole face of the world can be changed, it can be greatly improved.
ये चार बहुत ही आवश्यक अंग हैं समाज के, और इसको इसके लिए हम सबको अगर प्रेरित करें तो समाज में एक बहुत अच्छे सभ्य समाज की स्थापना कर सकते हैं.
We could just imagine how much the world would be improved if the people around the world would all become faithful to these four principles.
तो कल्पना करके देखिए, हम पूरा संसार आसपास के लोग कितने पवित्र हो जाएंगे अगर हम चार नियमों का पालन करेंगे.
Of course, we should understand these four principles don't make us into devotees. We may follow these principles without being a devotee. So it's important that in addition to these four principles, one also chants the holy name of God.
तो ये आवश्यक नहीं है सिर्फ कि हम ये चार नियम का पालन करें तो हम भक्त हो जाएंगे. बिना भक्त हुए भी लोग पालन करते हैं नियमों का, इसलिए भक्त होने उन नियमों के साथ साथ में भगवान के नाम का आश्रय करना होगा.
Actually, in every age, we know now we're in Kali Yuga, but other ages, Satya Yuga, the Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, in every age there was chanting of the holy names. But in Kali Yuga, there's only the chanting of the holy name. In the other ages, there were other processes as well as chanting the holy name. But in the Kali Yuga, there's no other way but by chanting the holy name.
तो ये भगवान का नाम का जो महत्व है वो सभी युग में था, सतयुग, द्वापर, त्रेता और कलयुग में. लेकिन बाकी युगों में और भी विधि थी, लेकिन कलयुग में केवल ही नाम आधार है और कोई विधि.
Therefore, devotees have to regularly chant. If they want to be initiated into Krishna consciousness, they have to chant every day a minimum of 16 rounds or malas on the japa beads, which have 108 beads. So this is a chanting which requires about 2 hours time in a day.
इसीलिए भक्तों को नियमित रूप से भगवान के नाम का जप करना चाहिए, कीर्तन करना चाहिए, और विशेष रूप से जो दीक्षा के लिए अग्रसर हो रहे हैं कम से कम 16 माला का जप उनको प्रतिदिन करना चाहिए, जिसके लिए कम से कम 2 घंटे का समय लग सकता है.
So we see the level of society at the present times is not very good. It takes some time for people to come to the standard, first of all, following 4 regulative principles, and then to regularly chant up to 16, minimum of 16 rounds a day.
इसलिए हम देखते हैं आज जो समाज है वो इतना पथभ्रष्ट है, क्योंकि वो लोग ये 4 नियम का पालन नहीं कर रहे हैं और साथ ही साथ में भगवान के नाम का जो आश्रय वो ग्रहण नहीं कर रहे हैं.
People sometimes question, they say, oh, this chanting on beads, this is nowhere, this is not common, we never saw this before, why you have to do that? But actually we see that all the great devas, demigods, they're all chanting on beads. We see Lord Brahma is holding beads, he's chanting, Lord Shiva also is chanting. Why you don't want to chant? You should chant. This is the dharma for the Kali Yuga.
लोग कभी कई बार लोग प्रश्न पूछते हैं कि अरे क्या आवश्यकता है माला में जप करने की, बस मन में करिए. माला में जप करने के लिए किसने बताया है, कहाँ पहले लोग कहाँ करते थे ऐसे? तो महाराज कह रहे हैं कि नहीं, आप देखिए जितने भी देवी देवता हैं, विशेष रूप से ब्रह्मा जी, शिव जी, ये सदैव माला पे जप करते हैं, भगवान के नाम पर जप करते हैं. तो क्यों नहीं जप करना है, संख्या पूर्वक जप करना है माला के ऊपर.
So the initiation is given into the chanting of the holy names. And with the initiation, you are also connected to the disciplic succession, which is called the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Vaishnav Sampradaya.
दूसरे हमको भगवान के नाम पर जप, संख्या पूर्वक जप, नाम का जप माला पे करना है. और ये हमको, ये जो दीक्षा की विधि है, ये हमको परंपरा से भी जोड़ती है, संप्रदाय से जोड़ती है. जैसे ये संप्रदाय जिसमें हम सबको दीक्षा मिल रही है, ये ब्रह्म मध्व गौड़ी संप्रदाय है.
Yeah, there are 4 bona fide Vaishnava sampradayas. Our particular line comes from Lord Brahma through Madhvacharya to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu are called Gaudiya Vaishnavas.
तो 4 प्रमाणिक वैष्णव संप्रदाय हैं, उसमें से ये ब्रह्म मध्व गौड़ी संप्रदाय, जिसमें चतुर महाप्रभु के आने के पश्चात इसका नाम गौड़ी इसमें जुड़ गया, गौड़ी संप्रदाय का.
There are actually altogether there are 4 Vaishnava sampradayas. One comes from Lord Shiva. The prominent acharya in the line from Lord Shiva is Vishnu Swami. Another line comes from the 4 Kumaras, and that's called known as the Nimbarka Sampradaya. And then we have the most famous, of course, the Sri Vaishnavas, which comes through Ramanujacharya.
तो जैसे कि जो रुद्र संप्रदाय जो भगवान शिव से आते हैं, उसमें विष्णु स्वामी वहाँ आचार्य हुए हैं, संप्रदाय के आचार्य. फिर उसके बाद निम्बार्क संप्रदाय जो 4 कुमार हैं, चतुष कुमार, वो संप्रदाय हैं. और उसके पश्चात फिर जो प्रसिद्ध संप्रदाय हैं, श्री संप्रदाय, जिसमें रामाचार्य महान आचार्य हुए हैं, और ये ब्रह्म मधु संप्रदाय जिसमें माध्वाचार्य संप्रदाय माध्वाचार्य हुए हैं.
So each of the 4 sampradayas have the same conclusion that the Lord, there's this one Supreme Lord and all the others are His servants.
और चारों संप्रदाय में ये निष्कर्ष उनके पास ये मत है कि भगवान ही एक ईश्वर है और बाकी सब उनके भृत्य हैं, उनके सेवक हैं.
So we don't support the impersonal philosophy that everyone is God, that we're all the supreme, and the goal is to merge into the oneness. We don't support this idea at all. We support the personal philosophy that the Lord is eternally the Supreme Lord, and we're eternally His servants.
तो ये निराकारवादी जो सिद्धांत है कि सभी लोग भगवान हैं, सब एक जैसे ही, एक समान हैं, सब एक हैं, इसका हम खंडन करते हैं संप्रदाय में. और हम लोग ये मत स्थापित करते हैं कि परम पुरुषोत्तम भगवान श्री कृष्ण और बाकी सब जो है ना वो उनके भृत्य हैं, सेवक हैं.
So we accept that the Lord is both personal and impersonal. He has his personal feature and he also has an impersonal feature. But we should understand that the Supreme Form is the personal form, which it contains everything.
तो भगवान का साकार रूप और उनका निराकार जो प्राकट्य है, हम दोनों को मानते हैं. लेकिन हम ये भी जानते हैं कि भगवान का जो साकार रूप है वो परम है और उसके द्वारा ही भगवान की पूर्ण अनुभूति कर सकते हैं.
For the impersonalists, generally they follow the line through Shankaracharya. He also has a disciplic succession, but their goal is to merge into the oneness, to achieve Sayujya Mukti. And they get that liberation only with great difficulty.
तो निराकार जो निर्विशेषवादी है, निराकार वो जो है उनके वो शंकराचार्य में उनका भी एक संप्रदाय है और वो उसमें सायुज्य मुक्ति वो उनके साथ में विलीन होना चाहते हैं, उस जो प्राकट्य जो प्रकाश है उसमें विलीन होना चाहते हैं.
And they only have realization of the Lord's impersonal feature. They don't understand that the Lord also has a personal feature. So those who are Vaishnavas, the devotees of the Lord, they know both the personal and the impersonal feature of the Supreme.
तो वो केवल निराकारवादी जो है वो भगवान के निराकार स्वरूप का ही अनुभूति कर पाते हैं. लेकिन जो भगवान के भक्त है वो भगवान के साकार और उनके जो सर्वव्यापी जो उनका गुण है वो दोनों का अनुभूति भगवान के भक्त कर पाते हैं.
So we are giving initiation today into the chanting of the holy names of Krishna. We chant the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This is a Vedic mantra, comes from the Vedas. And you can see it contains the names of God, Krishna and Rama, and Hare is the energy of the Lord.
तो आज यहाँ पर दीक्षा समाप्त हो रही है, दीक्षा दे रहे हैं और ये भगवान का नाम इसमें हम दे रहे हैं, हरे कृष्ण महामंत्र जिसमें कि भगवान का नाम है कृष्ण राम और हरे जो भगवान की शक्ति. तो ये वैदिक मंत्र है और वैदिक पद्धति के द्वारा ये दीक्षा दी जा रही है.
So the meaning of this mantra is given that our founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada described that it's a prayer. Meaning, O Supreme Lord Krishna, O Supreme Lord Rama, O Supreme Energy of the Lord Hari, please engage me in your service.
Srila Prabhupada ji is naam ka tatpari dete hain, is naam ki mahima ke baare mein batate hain, ki ye prarthna hai, aur kya prarthna kar rahe hain, ki he Bhagwan ki shakti, he Bhagwan Shri Krishna, he Bhagwan, jo sab varan pradan karne wale hain, Ram, कृपा करके मुझे अपनी सेवा में युक्त करिए.
So this is a prayer to the Supreme Lord and at the same time it's also the answer to the prayer because by chanting the holy name we're being engaged in the service of the Lord.
एक स्थिति में ये प्रार्थना है और ये प्रार्थना का प्रत्युत्तर भी है क्योंकि जब हम जप करते हैं इसका अर्थ है कि हम भगवान की सेवा में और युक्त हो रहे हैं तो हमको उसका उत्तर भी मिल रहा है.
So in the chanting of the holy name, there are some rules which have to be followed. There are actually 10 offenses which should be avoided in the daily chanting of the holy name. And the first offense is what we call the mad elephant offense. That is to blaspheme the devotees who have dedicated their lives to the propagation of the holy name of the Lord.
भगवान के नाम के जप करने में कुछ अपराध होते हैं, उन अपराधों से हमें बचना चाहिए, अपराध मुक्त नाम करना चाहिए और 10 अपराध बताए गए हैं. उसमें से पहला अपराध जो है उसको मत्त हाथी का अपराध कहा जाता है जो हमारे भक्ति को नष्ट कर सकती है.
So if we criticize or argue and fight with somebody who is a devotee of the Lord, it will not be good for our spiritual life.
अगर हम किसी से भक्तों से बात विवाद करें, उनसे झगड़ा करें, तो ये जो है ये हमारे आध्यात्मिक जीवन में उन्नति नहीं बल्कि पतन का कारण बने.
So we should be very careful in dealing with devotees. How to avoid fighting and offending them? The best thing to do is to glorify them and praise them and appreciate them and try to serve them.
तो हमें इससे बिल्कुल बचना चाहिए भक्तों का अपराध और उनसे कुछ झगड़ा नहीं हो अपराध नहीं हो. और ये कैसे हो सकता है जब हम उनकी हमेशा उनकी प्रशंसा करें उनकी सेवा करें उनके साथ मित्रत्व व्यवहार रखें.
So this is a very important offense. Always try to see the good in others and see the faults in ourselves. That's a very good principle to remember when we're doing devotional service.
तो दूसरों के हमेशा अच्छे गुणों को देखें और अपना दोष देखें. ये बहुत आवश्यक है हमारे आध्यात्मिक जीवन में. ये गुण होना बहुत आवश्यक है.
The second offense is to consider the names of demigods like Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma to be equal to or independent of the name of Lord Vishnu.
और दूसरा अपराध है हरि नाम के प्रति कि जो देवी देवता है विशेष रूप से उसमें जैसे ब्रह्मा जी शिव जी इनके नामों को भगवान के नाम के समान अथवा उनसे स्वतंत्र समझते.
We are following Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. There are 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu, and it is said at the end of the Vishnu Sahasranam, the 1,000 names of Vishnu, it is said there that one's chanting of the name of Ram is equal to the chanting of the 1,000 names of Lord Vishnu.
तो हम लोग चैतन्य महाप्रभु के अनुयायी हैं. चैतन्य महाप्रभु बताते हैं कितने भगवान के हजारों नाम हैं जैसे विष्णु सहस्र नाम. और उसके पश्चात बताया गया पुराण में कि किस प्रकार से भगवान राम का एक नाम जो है वो भगवान राम के तीन नाम जो है वो विष्णु के 1,000 नाम के समान है.
So the name of Lord Krishna is equal to 3 names of Ram. So we can understand 3,000 names of Vishnu is equal to 1 name of Lord Krishna.
और भगवान श्री कृष्ण का जो नाम है वो एक नाम वो राम के 3 नाम के समान बताए गए. इसका मतलब है एक हमने भगवान कृष्ण का नाम लिया तो 3,000 विष्णु सहस्रनाम 3 बार हम उसको बोल रहे हैं.
This is stated by Lord Shiva when he was instructing his wife Parvati. She was going to chant the 1,000 names of Vishnu. And Lord Shiva told his wife, you don't need to chant, just chant the name of Lord Ram.
So ये भगवान शिव बता रहे हैं पार्वती माँ को तन्न पुराण में कि जब वो कहें कि मैं जा रही हूँ विष्णु का नाम जपने के लिए कहा उनका कि नहीं आवश्यकता नहीं आप बस राम का नाम जपो 3 बार हो जाए.
Then the third offense is to disobey the order of the spiritual master. So the spiritual master, we're all under the shelter of the founder Acharya, His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. And Prabhupada has given us the instructions which we have to follow.
और तीसरा अपराध है गुरु की अवज्ञा करना अथवा उनको साधारण मनुष्य समझना. और हम सब जो हमारे संस्थापक आचार्य हैं श्री प्रभुपाद उनके सभी आदेशों का उनके निर्देशों का हमें पालन करना चाहिए.
And so we're working within the institution and we all the spiritual master is also a member of the institution. So we all work together under the guidance and instructions of Srila Prabhupada.
तो हम सभी ये एक संस्था है और हम सभी आध्यात्मिक गुरु भी श्री प्रभुपाद जी के इस संस्था में बनाए गए निर्देश उनके आदेश का ही पालन करते हैं.
Then the fourth offense is to blaspheme Vedic literature or any literature in pursuance of the Vedic version.
और चौथा अपराध है वैदिक शास्त्रों तथा प्रमाणों का खंडन करना.
This means we should read the books regularly. It's not enough just to chant Hare Krishna. We also have to read the scriptures And we have to learn to do different services, like worshipping the deity. So we shouldn't think that we can just imitate Haridas Thakur and just sit and chant. We have to also do other services. We have to hear the scriptures, and we should inquire also about the scriptures. And then we have to learn also how to serve the deities properly. And we have to celebrate the holy days. Just like yesterday was a holy day, yesterday was the holy Ekadasi. So on the Ekadasi day, we always observe fasting from grains and beans, and we try to increase our hearing and chanting. Regularly, we will chant 16 rounds on our beads. But on a Ekadasi day, we should chant a minimum of 25 rounds. Then the fifth offense is to consider the glories of chanting Hare Krishna to be imagination. In the scriptures, we may read that simply one time chanting the holy name of the Lord can destroy unlimited amounts of sins. So we may think, oh, I don't believe it. How is it possible? Just once chanting Krishna's name will destroy so many sins. No, it is possible. We have to understand these instructions with full faith. We have to understand that there's quality in the chanting of the holy name. So if you chant the holy name on the highest level, the pure name of the Lord, then you will get the maximum benefit and you will destroy unlimited amounts of sins. Then the sixth offense is to give some interpretation of the holy name. For example, the word Krishna can mean black. So someone may think, oh, black, something which is black is very mysterious. And so very difficult to know. So Krishna must be something which is very difficult to know, very mysterious. And then Hare can mean thief. So one may think, oh, Krishna is a thief. So in this way, we may speculate so many things about the meaning of the holy name of Krishna, and then we will never understand the real goal, which is to develop love of Krishna.
Krishna इन शब्दों के अर्थ को निकालना और समझना, इससे हम कभी भी सत्य नहीं समझ पाएंगे. तो ये है अर्थवाद का आरोप.
So we want to understand the holy name, we have to understand it with the help of the disciplic succession through the acharyas. They will guide us properly to understand the full meaning of the holy name.
इसीलिए भगवान के नाम के महिमा को समझने के लिए, उनके अर्थ को समझने के लिए हमको आचार्यों के माध्यम से, जो पूर्ववर्ती प्रामाणिक आचार्य हैं उनके माध्यम से ही समझना चाहिए उसका वास्तविक अर्थ क्या है.
Then the seventh offense is to commit sinful activities on the strength of chanting the holy name.
और सातवां अपराध नाम के बल पर पाप करना.
Someone may think that, oh, I did some sinful activities, or tonight I'm going to do something sinful. Tonight I'm not going to be very strict. Maybe I'll drink some alcohol. Maybe I'll eat some non-vegetarian food. Anyway, we think, oh, it doesn't matter. I'll chant more tomorrow to make up for it. Then that is an offense if we think like that.
तो ऐसा सोचना कि आज ठीक है, आज मैं कुछ तो कुछ मुझसे पाप हो जाएगा तो कोई बात नहीं, आज मैं कर लूँगा, कुछ मांसाहार खा लूँगा, कुछ नशा कर लूँगा, कोई बात नहीं, कल सुबह मैं अच्छे से जप कर लूँगा तो उससे मैं मुझे मुक्ति मिल जाएगी. तो इस प्रकार से समझ करके पाप करना नाम के बल पर, ये अपराध है.
So we see in Srimad Bhagavatam the story of Ajamila. Ajamila was committing sinful activities and he was also calling the name of his son. He was calling the Lord's name Narayan. But he was not thinking that by chanting Narayan I'm going to destroy my sins. He was simply calling the name of his son.
तुम देखते हो श्रीमद् भागवत में अजामिली रथा थे, किस प्रकार से वो जब अपने पापों में युक्त थे और जब अंत में अंत समय में अपने पुत्र को पुकारते हैं जब यमदूत को देख करके, तो वो उस समय ये नहीं समझते हैं कि ठीक है मैं ये पुकार रहा हूँ नारायण का नाम से मेरे पाप जाए. नहीं, वो केवल असहाय अवस्था में अपने पुत्र के नाम को पुकार रहे थे नारायण का.
But if we think, oh, I'm just going to use the holy name so that I can do sinful activities, then it's a great offense, very serious.
तो कोई अगर ये सोचे कि ठीक है मैं तो नाम जप रहा हूँ लेकिन अगर कोई मुझसे पाप भी होता है तो ये नाम मुझे उससे मुक्ति ला देंगे और उसके बल पर पाप करते जा रहे हैं, तो ये बहुत बड़ा अपराध है.
Then the eighth offense is to consider chanting Hare Krishna to be one of the auspicious ritualistic activities offered in the Vedas as karmakanda or fruitive activities.
तो आठ हरे कृष्ण महिमा, हरे महामंत्र की महिमा को, भगवान के नाम की महिमा को वेदों में वर्णित एक शुभ सकाम कर्म अथवा कर्मकांड के समान समझते.
Someone may think that by chanting Hare Krishna, I'll get a lot of pious activities and I'll enjoy sense gratification more. I'll get more money, I'll get more opulence, my material life will be more comfortable. So this is not pure chanting.
We agree socially that I am chanting Bhagwan's name, then it will be very good. And it will be a great life, it will be a great life, and then I will also be able to focus on it. If you are chanting this way, then this is a good job.
Pure chanting is where we chant simply for the pleasure of Lord Krishna. We simply want to please Krishna by our chanting. We are calling his holy name and we want to please him.
Shuddha jap wo hai jisme keval bhagwan ko prasann karne ke liye, unki seva ke dwara unko prasann karne ke liye hum keval jap kare, unko pukare, usse ko shuddha jap kaha jata hai.
Then the ninth offense should be understood carefully, that it is an offense to instruct the glories of the holy name to faithless persons.
और नौवां अपराध किसी अश्रद्धालु व्यक्ति को नाम की महिमा का उपदेश देना.
We can tell anyone to chant the holy name, but we don't tell them all the glories and the special powers behind chanting the holy name until they've developed faith in Krishna consciousness.
हम सबको बोलते हैं अरे भगवान के नाम का जप करने के लिए, लेकिन उस नाम की महिमा को, उनकी शक्ति को, नाम के प्रभाव को ही हम सबको नहीं बोलते.
We do go around giving everyone the holy name and requesting them to chant Hare Krishna, but we don't tell them all the special benefits you get from chanting.
तो हम सबको जब जाते हैं प्रचार के लिए सबको बोलते हैं कि आप हरे नाम का जप करें, लेकिन उससे क्या वास्तविक लाभ मिलने वाला है पर हम लाभ भी सबको हम नहीं बताते.
But we do tell them that chanting Hare Krishna will help us to understand we're not the body, that we're spirit souls, and that we're not in control of our mind and senses, but chanting Hare Krishna will help us to get control over the mind and senses.
लेकिन सबको ये बोल सकते हैं कि हम शरीर नहीं हैं, हम आत्मा हैं, और हमारा अनियंत्रित मन जो है ये भगवान के नाम के जप से ये नियंत्रण में आ जाए, ये बात हम सबको बोल सकते हैं.
And then finally, the 10th offense is not to have complete faith in chanting Hare Krishna and maintain material attachment, even after receiving many instructions in this matter.
और दसवां अपराध की भगवान के नाम की इतनी प्रगाढ़ महिमा सुनने पर भी उस भगवान के नाम पर पूर्ण विश्वास नहीं होना और इतनी अगाध महिमा सुनने के पश्चात भी विषय आसक्ति बनाए.
If we hold on to our material attachments, material desires, then it will be very difficult to make spiritual progress. We have to be willing to let go. So, vairagya, detachment, is very important.
So, adhyatmik unnati karte hue, agar hum soche ki bhautik jeevan bhi hamara, usko bhi pakad ke rakhe saath mein, usse vairagya nahi aaye, to is saath mein nahi hota hai. Humko dheeme dheeme bhautik cheezon ko tyagna hoga.
And then, after these 10 offenses, it's also added that it's also offensive to be inattentive while chanting. And every devotee who claims to be a Vaishnav must carefully guard against these offenses in order to quickly achieve the desired success, Krishna Prem.
And in this aparadho ke atrikt, ye bhi ek aparad hai ki bhagwan ka jap karte samay savdhan nahi rehna. और जो भी अपने आप को वैष्णव कहते हैं या वैष्णव बनना चाहते हैं उनको चाहिए कि इन 10 अपराधों से पूर्ण रूप से अपने आप को सुरक्षित करें जिससे कि जो इच्छित फल है कृष्ण प्रेम उसकी ओर हम उन्मुख हो सके.
And so when we do our japa, we should try to do the japa in an environment where it's conducive, where it's suitable for controlling our mind. If there's a lot of other distractions, then it will be very difficult to concentrate on the chanting of the holy name.
So, जब भी हम जप के लिए बैठे तो ऐसे अनुकूल वातावरण में बैठे जहाँ पर कि वो हमारे जप के लिए बहुत अनुकूल हो. ऐसा नहीं कि वहाँ पर बहुत विचलन हो, बहुत विचलन वाले वातावरण में बैठकर कि हम जप ध्यान रोक नहीं कर सकते.
And so devotees, they should have an altar, you should have some kind of little altar or temple room where you can chant, and especially when you cook, you will want to offer your food, so you should offer the food there at the altar, and in this way you can make your own prasadam.
So, jaise bhakt hote hain to apne ghar mein बहुत सुंदर ऑल्टर रखते हैं, भगवान के छवि को या विग्रह को रखते हैं, उनकी सेवा करते हैं, वहाँ पर जप कर सकते हैं, और फिर कुछ भोग बनाए तो ऑल्टर में लाके भगवान को अर्पित करें, इस प्रकार से आध्यात्मिक उन्नति कर सकते हैं.
So today we are giving initiation to one devotee, Amit Prabhu from Kanayadesh, and I've been associating with him for some years now, and I've stayed in his home and I've seen how he worships. His wife is also a Vaishnava, and they have children also who are very respectful and also interested in the teachings of Krishna consciousness.
So Maharaj बहुत ही कृपालु हैं और आज यहाँ पर हरियादेश में अमित प्रभु जी को अमित प्रभु और उनको आज दीक्षा मिलने वाली है. महाराज यहाँ पर आ चुके हैं, प्रभु के घर में रह चुके हैं, माता जी स्वयं वैष्णव हैं वो भी, और उनके जो दो सुपुत्र हैं, ये पूरा परिवार मिलके बहुत अच्छे से भगवान की सेवा कर रहे हैं यहाँ पर दुनिया देश में अपने घर.
His wife and she regularly daily serves them nice offerings and dresses them very nice standard. The very sattvic people. So I feel honored to have the opportunity to give the husband initiation today.
So Mata ji jo hai wo bahut sundar roop se seva bachpan se ho vaishnav parivar mein jaram hua hai unka, भगवान के लिए भोग बनाना, उनके लिए बहुत अच्छा श्रृंगार करना, वस्त्र बनाना। और तो महाराज कह रहे हैं कि वो सब उन्होंने महाराज स्वयं देखा है और महाराज बहुत प्रसन्न है इनको दीक्षा देते हुए प्रभु जी को।
So, Prabhu has been through all the procedures required for initiation, doing such things as attending the disciple course, where he's instructed about the policies in ISKCON and the management structure of ISKCON.
तो और प्रभु जी भी जो ISKCON के जो नियम है दीक्षा के पूर्व उसको पूर्ण कर चुके हैं, जैसे कि ISKCON disciple course उसको पूर्ण कर चुके हैं और उससे वो समझ चुके हैं कि किस प्रकार से संस्था में ये जो गुरु शिष्य का संबंध है और ये प्रणाली कैसे कार्य करती है।
And he has also the recommendation from the management council there in Kanayadesh. They're approving my giving him initiation. They say yes, he's qualified, he's a worthy person.
और प्रभु जी का जो एक और भी जो नियम होता है कि वो यात्रा से रिकमेंडेशन जाता है, तो वो भी महाराज को मिल चुका है कि प्रभु जी ये विनती कर रहे हैं इस कृपा को प्राप्त करने के लिए।
Of course, I'm not staying there, so I don't know what happens regularly. But those of you who are there regularly, you know, and you're therefore, I trust your recommendation. Following your recommendation, I'm very happy to accept him and give him initiation and bring him into ISKCON and connect him also to the disciplic succession, all the previous acharyas.
महाराज कह रहे हैं कि हालांकि मैं वहाँ पर नियमित रूप से हूँ, लेकिन वहाँ पर जो भक्तगण है, जो वहाँ से रिकमेंडेशन आई है, उससे ज्ञात होता है कि किस प्रकार से ये वहाँ पर युक्त है और भक्तों के संपर्क में और इस प्रकार से गुरु शिष्य परंपरा से युक्त है।
Lord Krishna told Uddhava that if someone said he is my devotee, Lord Krishna said he's not really my devotee. But if he's a devotee of my devotee, then he's my devotee. So Lord Krishna tells us that we shouldn't try to become Krishna conscious independent of devotees. We need to have the shelter and the help and the blessings of devotees to approach Krishna.
Bhagavan Shri Krishna कहते हैं कि अगर कोई कहता है कि वो मेरे भक्त है प्रत्यक्ष, तो मैं उनको अपना भक्त नहीं मानता, लेकिन जो कहते हैं कि मैं आपके भक्तों का भक्त हूँ, तो वो मेरे भक्त है। इसका महाराज कह रहे हैं कि इसलिए हम सबको स्वतंत्र रूप से कृष्ण भावना भावित अभ्यास नहीं करना चाहिए। हमारा कृष्ण भावना भावित अभ्यास भी भक्तों के ऊपर आश्रित होकर के भक्तों के संग में होना चाहिए।
We may go for a job, just like you go for a job. They will want references. They want other people to give you a reference. You know, what are you like? Character reference and so on. So similarly also, to be accepted into Lord Krishna's association, we need also the recommendation from the devotees.
So जैसे हम जाते हैं जब जॉब के लिए, तो वहाँ पर लोग देखते हैं हमारे CV में कि references किसके हैं, किसने आपको अवलोकित किया है। उसी प्रकार जब भक्तों के संग में भी आते हैं, और विशेष रूप से दीक्षा के लिए नियम है कि जो recommendation है वो भी जाना चाहिए कि ठीक है, हाँ भक्त जानते हैं इनको, सेवा में युक्त है वहाँ पर।
So, Amit Prabhu is there. We will ask him. We want to ask him. What are the four regulative principles you're going to follow, Prabhu?
Yes, yes, Maharaj. Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Maharaj, there are four regulative principles that I'm following and I'll keep on following. First is no meat eating. Second is no illicit sex. Third is no gambling. And fourth is no intoxication.
Right.
But keep on following it very strictly.
Yes, right. We also, when we say no meat, it includes also fish and eggs. And also we don't take the rajasic foods like onion and garlic. These things should be avoided.
Yes, Maharaj. So we are not having any of these.
Yes. Right. You're very fortunate. Your wife is a Vaishnava. She's a devotee. So you have a very good opportunity to become Krishna conscious. So Chaitanya Charu Prabhu is here in Mayapur. He's also
yes.
from Kannada.
Yes, Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj. And we are very grateful to you, Maharaj, that you chanted on the beats
Yes.
And that beach that will come here, Maharaj, very soon.
Right. Right, I chanted on the beads. He brought very nice beads for me, and I chanted on them. Very nice big Tosi beads, and I chanted on them, so they'll be given to you.
Yes, Maharaj. Sorry, Maharaj, we are offering to garland to you, Maharaj. Please accept it.
Oh, okay, thank you. Hare Krishna. Very kind, yes. Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Maharaj, here a few devotees has assembled along with the family.
Oh, yeah.
Lockdown. Otherwise, we would have done the big program in the hall. But due to the situation of, again, COVID-19, so a few devotees have assembled here, Maharaj, right from the beginning.
Oh, everything locked down there, yeah?
Yes, Maharaj, going to very soon now.
Oh. Yeah, we're also not doing very well here in Mayapur. Quite a few cases of COVID.
Yes, Maharaj, we heard Maharaj. We all are praying, Maharaj. We are praying for your good health, Maharaj.
Today is the auspicious day of the Ganga Sagar Mela, where Kapila Muni's ashram is. So I thought, you know, there's so many inauspicious things. Let's try to do something auspicious to counteract all the inauspiciousness.
Thank you, Maharaj.
We're very sorry. Just this morning we got news His Holiness Jagpataka Swami is not well, and he's off to Calcutta to go to hospital there to see doctors there. He had a difficult night last night, and early this morning he vomited, and so they decided to take him to Calcutta to get some consultation there. So we're all praying for him. Of course, he's very, very, very dear to all of us, and very, very, very important for our ISKCON society and for the development of the Mayapur project. So we pray to Lord Krishna to please protect him, and also please protect all our other devotees who are suffering with COVID just now. We have more than 100 cases here in Mayapur.
We all will pray, Maharaj. We all will pray sincerely, Maharaj.
Very good. Thank you very much. So I chanted on the beat, so I just have to give you a name. So I thought a nice name for you would be Abhiram Das. Abhiram.
Abhiram Prabhuji ki jai.
Yeah. Abhiram Das Thakur was a great devotee of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So I hope that name will suit you, and yeah, I hope you can use it. Okay, so...
Thank you, Maharaj. We are very grateful to you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you for accepting me as your backup.
Okay, thank you for accepting me as your spiritual guide. And of course, you're also... You should also have mentors. You should have also Shiksha Gurus. I'm just giving you initiation on behalf of our society. But within our society, there are many spiritual masters. And you please also respect all of them equally, that they're all representatives of Krishna. Don't just think I am your guru. And you try to see all the other devotees also in an equal way. That will be very nice.
I follow that, sir.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Okay, so thank you, Maharaj. Hare Krishna. Nice to see you all. Okay, anybody has any questions? Anything before I go off, because I have a lot of things to do today. I have a busy day.
Very good, Maharaj, and we heard such a wonderful class, Maharaj. And not only for Prabhuji, I think all of us, we heard it was such a nice reminder for all of us, Maharaj, to follow these 10 offenses against, we have to guard against 10 offenses, and also significance of this wonderful initiation ceremony, Maharaj. So we'll always keep in our heart whatever we have heard today.
Okay.
And we'll try to implement in our life, Maharaj, with your blessings, Maharaj.
Thank you.
We are very, very grateful to you, Maharaj. Thank you so much, Maharaj. And very glad you're waiting for your arrival here in Kuwait whenever the situation becomes out.
Okay, I'm waiting for your arrival here in Mayapur also.
Thank you so much, Maharaj. Thank you so much.
Okay, Prabhu. So I'll sign off now then. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki.
Yeah.
Go back to Vrinda ki. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Recording stopped.